Today we start a course on developing a text editor, which will be a better version of Notepad. Let's create a Windows Forms application and call the project Text Editor. We will start with adding basic elements of any text editor. The most important one is a control for user input. I suggest using a Richtexbox. Click on the arrow near its top right corner and click Dock in Parent Container. Now it fills the space completely, but we also need a menu. There are many options, but I suggest using a menu strip. We need to add it to a menu item, which will be our file menu. Click on it to expand on its dependent elements and type save. For now, I need only to make the program know whether the text is saved or not. Double-click on it to modify its click event, the type of variable which decides whether something is true or false is bool. After the variable type, write its name and make it equal to false. You need to type semicolon at the end of lines very often. In the button click event, we'll make its value true. Now we need to know when it is not true. Usually text is not saved when it changes. So let's change the text change event of the rich text box. Double click on it. Here we make it equal to false. Finally, we will use the bool variable to check whether the text was saved when we try to close the app. That event is called from closing. We need to show a message to a user warning him about the text. We can access that message through the MessageBox class and use the show method. In brackets, type your warning. Let's test it. So it works. Now let's add a header to the message. That is the second argument. And now let's also add buttons for user to decide whether to close the app or not. The third argument is MessageBox buttons. After a period, select buttons most appropriate for your app. I will use OK cancel. Of course, this message must be shown only if saved equals false. Use the if operator for conditions. In brackets, write the condition which is saved. Double equals false. Remember, you write one equal sign if you give values and two if you make conditions. The action which occurs when the condition is met is executed as a block. You can write it in the next single line or add a whole statement block. I added the if structure. The beginning and end of blocks are defined by curly braces. And inside this block we put another condition. This way we can check if a certain button was hit. For instance, we can ask the user whether he wants to exit. If he hits cancel, the closing process will cancel. Type E, which is the form closing event argument, period, cancel, equals true. In the next video, I will show you how to create new text and how to open files. Thanks for watching!